Hey Hygienists, welcome to my channel. I'm Kalesha and I'm a registered dental hygienist. I post dental hygiene related content here on YouTube every single Friday. So if that's something you're interested in, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you can see what I do, know what I know, and you yourself can become a dental hygienist too. If you're a returning subscriber, hey girl, hey! Shout out to you for joining me for another video on today. So I'm super excited to be sitting down talking to you all again. The last few videos, we've been in the op, we've been working, we've been busy, okay? In my last sit down chit chat video, we kind of discussed time management skills. And I did the 20-20-20 challenge that kind of gives you a guideline of what to do within each 20 minute session that equals up to an hour that we usually have with our patients. So I got a good response after that video and I thought I wanted to go a little bit deeper into what goes on in an hour and give you all some even more practical time-saving tips that could help you even more during that hour appointment. So let's get right into these 8 time-saving tips to help you, my friend, as a dental hygienist. Now the first thing you want to do is check your patient's insurance the day before their appointment. Now I live by this. At the end of my day, I like to go ahead and look at tomorrow's schedule. I like to go over the patient's insurance and go ahead and put into the appointment what they're eligible for. Go over their patient note and know what we talked about last time. That way I can reinforce it and know what I'm in for when that patient walks in my operatory. I don't ever want to let a patient be seated and then have to review everything while they're in the room, because again, that wastes time. So highly recommend you to go over your patient's insurance the day before, or come earlier to work and go over your patients for their day, go over their insurance. If they need x-rays and their dental insurance only covers it once a year, then you know that you may not be able to take x-rays that day unless you talk to the patient and let them know, hey, you're at a higher risk for cavities. I think we should do x-rays every 6 months, and let the patient know that they'll have to cover it themselves. But it's very critical that you yourself know a little bit about dental insurance so that you can read the forms that the front desk provides and you can explain to your patient that, hey, your insurance does or doesn't cover this, but this is what I think you need, so that they're not caught off guard if you just do anything and then we bill it to insurance and they get a bill later on. Most patients are not happy about that. So do your homework before your patient gets in your seat. It'll save you some time and trouble. Time-saving tip number 2, use questionnaires and templates for an easy documentation. Now, we know how important documentation is. I feel like I've stressed this in probably the last 4 sit-down videos, because documentation is so important. It saves you from liability lawsuits. It also keeps you engaged with your patient. If you jot down personal notes, you're able to check in with that family member that may have been ill, or that senior that's graduated from high school and about to go to college. It's going to be critical that you keep these notes so that your patient has a personal relationship with you and they know that you know a little bit about them at each appointment. Also, it keeps up with their periodontal health. You know, it lets you know the condition that they're currently in, what you all are working towards, and what you need to be educating them on. Now, I went over questionnaires in my previous video, and I've also touched on templates a lot in my Day in the Life vlogs. So definitely recommend you check those out. Just to quickly go over what a questionnaire is, here at my clinic, we use caries risk assessment surveys that gives us an idea of the patient's home life as far as if they use any fluoride toothpaste, if they drink, if they consume a lot of sweets, if they floss daily, so forth and so on. And it lets us know if they're at a higher or lower risk for cavities. That way we know if we need to include fluoride in their visits. That way we know if we need to take x-rays more frequently and things of such. And another questionnaire we use is the periodontal assessment. We do these questionnaires yearly, but they're just quick click of the button. It takes about 2 to 3 seconds to fill them out. So of course that definitely saves some time. So the questionnaires are usually done before the appointment when you're having a conversation with your patient. But the templates are usually done after the visit with the patient, when you have a general view of everything and you're just reviewing the whole appointment in that note. So it's definitely gonna be a good idea to have a template that helps you, again, click, 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 maybe type a few notes in, but it only takes about 2 to 3 minutes instead of having to individually type every single detail. You have just templates already up. Time saving tip number 3, keep your operatory stocked. Oh my God, I hate running out of stuff in the middle of an appointment. It just irks me, and it's not a good thing for you to have to leave your operatory and leave your patient alone to go and get something that you should have been prepared for. You know what I'm saying? Now, some things may come up in the appointment that you didn't plan, and you have to leave the room. That's okay. But if you can't avoid it, have any single thing that you know you as a hygienist may use in your operatory, of course, if you have the storage for it. So I have this huge storage unit in my room along with some cubbies right beside my computer that gives me an ample amount of storage, and I'm so grateful for it because I'm always making sure that each drawer is stocked with anything I need so that everything is either at arm's reach or at least in the vicinity when I need it. It keeps me looking like I prepare for my patient, and it also, of course, saves time. When you're organized and everything is right where you need it, right where you left it, it helps the appointment just flow seamlessly. And it looks good to your patient when you seem to be put together and you know what they need before they even say they need it. So keep your operatory stocked. It's gonna help you throughout that appointment and in the long run of just being an organized and put together person, okay? So the 4th time-saving tip.
No.
Is have a mock tray set up. Now, a tray is this thing here behind me. Usually what you're gonna need at every single appointment will be here on this tray, which will be your instruments, your suction tip, your barriers, your gauze, your floss, your prophy paste, your prophy angle, and maybe your actual prophy handle. So those are just some things I keep on my tray from appointment to appointment. At the end of each working day, I go ahead and make some mock tray setup for the number of patients I have on the next day. So all I do is I lay out a white sheet of paper, which is gonna be the barrier between my instruments and any dirty gauze or dirty floss, anything I wanna sit on it, between that and the tray, actual tray. So I sit down a piece of white paper, I go ahead and put my gauze, my suction, my floss, my patient bib, and my prophy paste on it. And I just stack them all on top of each other so that they're ready to go. Mock tray setups will help you break down and set your room back up in seconds, y'all, in seconds. You just wipe the surfaces down, take your instruments to the cleaner, come back, and all you do is grab that mock tray setup and place it right back on the tray, and you're ready to go. So having these essentials already in a designated space, so all you have to do is grab, place, and go, that'll help you save some time. Time saving tip number 5, make pre-made patient to-go bags. Now, I know each single patient's individualized care is different. The things that you're gonna recommend is gonna be different from patient to patient, but the things that you do know you're gonna give each patient, go ahead and put them in a bag. This is gonna be toothbrush, toothpaste, and floss. Now, if you have different types of toothbrushes, yes, you can change it out or make a separate bag for this type of toothbrush and make a different bag for this type of toothbrush. Or if you have different toothpaste and you know your patient needs sensitive or your patients mostly need a regular, you just make a bunch of bags with sensitive, make a bunch of bags with regular, or just make all regular and as each patient needs, take that one tube of toothpaste out and replace it with the sensitive. But ultimately, you know that they're gonna need toothpaste, toothbrush, and floss to go with them. So go ahead and make up a bunch of bags, and then you can add and take away as needed. This is gonna make sure that you're not shuffling around looking for the right toothbrush or looking for the right toothpaste, but you already have it right in a drawer, ready to go. All you have to do is put their next appointment card in it, hand them to it, and say, got your next 6 months appointment scheduled. Here's what you're gonna need in between now and then. Of course, this may not suffice for that entire 6 months, but these are the things I recommend, and if need be, you can always find it at your local store and replace it. So this is just gonna help you look like you are prepared, you know what they need, you have the recommendations together, and again, it saves you some time. Time saving tip number 6 may sound a little crazy at first, but I promise after I explain it, it's gonna make perfect sense. So I love to let the patient hold the straw. I know you're probably like, girl, you got your patients in there working. Yes, yes, but in my defense, most of the patients when I started working at this job was already used to holding the straw. So as soon as you get ready to get going, they're like, I'll get that straw. And I'm like, yes, oh my God, because that saves me some time. Letting the patient hold the straw makes so much sense because when after you're scaling and you're, of course, you got a lot of blood in the mouth, a lot of plaque in the mouth that you don't want the patient to swallow. So you have to rinse and suction often. And to grab the suction and the water syringe, you have to put your instruments down. So there's a lot of putting down, picking up, and doing all of that. If the patient already has the straw, all you have to do is grab the water. You can keep your mirror in your hand. Maybe sit down just your working instrument because, you know, you don't want to poke them in the eye or poke them in the face or the jaw or anything like that. So you just put your instrument down, grab the water syringe, spray, let them swish, and let them suction themselves. Now, sometimes you get a patient here and there that likes to suction for a minute almost, and you have to let them know, all right, I think you got it all, you know, nicely, but just let them know you think you got it all. But most of them are pretty quick. And it just saves you a lot of reaching, a lot of putting down, and a lot of replacing. So thus, it saves you some time. May not be a whole lot of time, but literally every minute to every second matters within that 60 minutes. So if your patient's up to it, just try it. Hey, would you like to hold this straw so that you're in control of whenever you need to spit? You know, sometimes I get the cleaning and I forget that you can't swallow. So I always like for my patients to hold this straw so that they never have to wait on me for the suction. And most of them are like, yeah, I love that. Thanks. I actually like this better, you know. And that way, that'll save you some time and make your job a little bit easier. So try it. I promise it'll save you a little bit of time. Time saving tip number 7. Get the doctor prior to polishing. Now, I don't do this very often unless I'm really behind on my patient and I need my doctor to walk in and check either before I'm completely finished or right when I get done. So what we use is a little note card with our name, the operatory we're in, the patient, and a few little notes that we want the doctor to know or some things that we suspect or some things we want the doctor to mention prior to coming in to make it again seem like they know what's going on, that they've been briefed, and that they're here to take care of the patient's needs. We use this patient card, one, because it's time efficient, and two, because we don't like to go in and disturb the dentist when they're with another patient by saying, hey, I'm ready for you. So instead, we just hold our card up, get their attention a little bit, and put it right where they're working so that when they get to a stopping point, they know that, okay, I have to go and see Kalesha in op number 5. And this is the patient, and this is what I'm looking forward to walking into. So not only will this prepare your doctor, but of course this saves you some time because if you go and get the doctor before you start polishing, usually they're not at a stopping point right now, and that lets them know that, hey, I'll need you in about 5 minutes. It's gonna take me 5 minutes to polish and floss, if that. So it gives you a little bit more time to do what you're doing and then get up and come check my patient. So that'll just, again, help the appointment flow so that the patient is not sitting idle for 10 to 20 minutes waiting on a doctor exam that literally only takes about 3 minutes to do. So use your time wisely and respect the patient's time, although they may not respect yours by being late sometime, but we ain't gonna talk about that. Respect the patient's time by going to get the doctor before, that way that the appointment flows seamlessly. Time saving tip number 8 is to let the front desk schedule restorative treatment. Now the reason I say this is not because I don't think that's my responsibility, but I say this because usually restorative treatment is needed sooner than just a regular 6-month recall appointment. So for the recall appointments, patients usually are like, okay, just plug it in on a day. I don't know what I'm doing 6 months from now. I'll call you closer it gets if I need to reschedule. So it's much easier for you as a hygienist back while you have the patient in the room to go ahead and schedule their next cleaning. No problem. But if they need a root canal or filling or crown, this is urgent, okay? They have to come back within a few weeks, few days, or a month or so. And that means you have to shuffle through the schedule, find a day that correlates with when they're free. You know, so it can take 2 to 5 minutes just to get an appointment scheduled, and you need that patient out your op because you got another one coming in a few minutes. You know what I'm saying? So politely say, hey, I'm gonna get your 6-month appointment scheduled, and the front desk will schedule you back for that filling. That way you just escort them up to the front and say, hey, Jim needs a DO on number 5. Can you get him scheduled in the next few weeks with Dr. Whomever? That way the front desk can take their time and find a day that correlates with our schedule and their patients, and that leaves you free to go back to your room, break it down, and set up for your next patient. And another reason why I feel like it's important for the front desk to schedule restorative treatment is because most patients want to know what this procedure is going to cost them, what their insurance covers, and what they'll have to pay out of pocket. And front desk will know those answers almost to the T before you will. So that just keeps you from having to go over this whole conversation or trying to dig and figure out what insurance helps with and what they'll be paying. Just put that off on the front desk. That's what they're there for, and we all work together. They schedule the restorative and we schedule our own, and we schedule our own hygiene recall appointment. Trust me, seems small, but any little thing helps. So that concludes today's video on a few time-saving tips for you inside the operatory. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and share it with a hygienist that you know. Be sure to hit that subscribe button so that you yourself can become a dental hygienist. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye, Hygienists.